Hello, my name is Chris, if you didn't already know, and welcome to my show, Smeg Chris Review. Before I review a movie, I want to talk about a television show that I've just watched. It's called Miracle Workers, and it stars Daniel Radcliffe and Steve Buscemi, who also produce it. And I have to say, it is absolutely hilarious. Steve Buscemi plays God, and his role is just absolutely phenomenal. It was like it was born to play that character. And Daniel Radcliffe was a joy to watch as well. It also starred... I'm trying to remember her name, but I can't. So if you ever see this, forgive me, but I'm going to have to go and look it up. She was in Blockers. It's a good thing I've got all these DVDs here, isn't it? And of course, her name isn't on the box. Ugh, come on. I'm going to have to look it up. Where's my phone? This is a problem when you're not scripting your videos anymore. Yeah, I'm just finding out there's going to be a second season. I did not know that. I'm glad, though. Anyway, her name is Geraldine Viswanathan. Viswanathan, something like that. This young lady, who also put in a great performance. So basically the story is that all these characters work for Heaven Inc. So of course Steve Buscemi as God is the CEO of that. So Geraldine plays a character called Eliza, who goes off to work with a character called Craig, played by Daniel Radcliffe. And their job is to perform little miracles for people on Earth. Then Eliza discovers that there's a great big pile that have all got stamped on them, impossible, and then they're sent up to God. But she finds out that he's not even doing that, he's just... well, bit of a layabout, really. In fact, God's decided that he's come up with this other great idea and he doesn't need Earth anymore, so he's going to blow it up. And so Eliza makes a bet with God that if she manages to make one of these impossible miracles happen, he doesn't blow up Earth. And of course, God agrees to this. And so that's what the whole series is all about, trying to save Earth by performing one of these impossible miracles. There are only 10 episodes so far, and they're roughly 20 minutes long each. So of course, I binge-watched them. And I'm so glad I did, because I was laughing most of the way through the series. There are some jokes that are a bit hit and miss, but overall it's very funny. And I totally recommend watching it. And I'm so happy I've just found out that there's going to be another series. Now onto my movie review of Bad Boys for Life. I've always enjoyed the Bad Boys films, especially the second one. So I couldn't wait for them to do a third one. And I've been waiting a long time. So does it live up to the other two? More or less. For starters, you can tell it's not directed by Michael Bay because there aren't explosions everywhere, cars flipping all over the place, bullet holes showing up and everything. Although he does make a cameo, which was interesting. But don't get me wrong, it's still an action film, just not as much as the first two. Which allows for more character development and more story. Which delves more into Mike's past, which was very interesting. One of the story elements I enjoyed was that Marcus becomes a grandfather and then he retires. And what comes of that is hilarious. Of course, he doesn't stay retired too long. He does get back into it. I mean, it's called Bad Boys for Life, so... but it's not all humour. There are a lot of serious moments, a lot of drama, but, you know, plenty of action too. There's a bike chase scene that I absolutely loved. And it was a little over the top, but not Michael Bay over the top. Another thing I enjoyed was that we kept hearing some of the original Bad Boys theme. That gave me chills. As you can expect from these films, there is a big battle sequence at the end. This time it takes place in Mexico. There is a pretty decent ending to that, but you have this little feeling that they may do another one. But don't take my word on that, I'm only guessing. Overall, I give Bad Boys for Life a... it's definitely a worthy sequel. I just wish they didn't wait too long to do it. And that's it for this episode. All that's left for me to say now is thank you for watching and subscribing if you have, and liking this video if you did. Until the next time, peace out. Can't believe that the first Bad Boys came out in 1995. 25 years ago. I was so young, I was only 20. I mean, I thought it was long enough before they did a Bad Boys 2, which was 2003. So 8 years had passed by then, and after that I was always wanting them to do a third one. But the more time went on, the less likely it was going to happen. Until one day Will Smith declared, "We're doing another Bad Boys!" And I was like, yes! I'm so glad they did. But 25 years in between the first and this one, I feel old.